tackle will be a 6'3", 183-pound sophomore, Tyler Walker. Left guard will be a 6'1", 170-pound sophomore, Wes Scobie. Your center, Zane Gilbreth, a 6'...
Had a great game last week.
Yep, a 6', 176-pound sophomore. Right guard, a 5'9", 191, and a junior is Anthony Tisman. The right tackle at 6'2", 210, a sophomore, Chandler Lamb. Tight end, Wilson Dalton, a 5'11", 170-pound sophomore. One wide receiver, A.J. Davis, 5'11", 166 pounds as a junior. Another wide receiver, Corbin Wood, if he can go. And the other one, Isaiah Jackson, a 5'8", 164-pound freshman. Your back is Bryce Abbott, also a freshman, 5'9", 213 pounds. And your quarterback, Ross Pearson, a 6', 155-pound senior. Defensively, it's pretty much all the same people. Chandler and Ethan Daywald is a 6', 226-pound defensive tackle. At one end will be Anthony Tisman. The other end will be Tyler Walker. Your outside linebackers, Gilbreth and Dalton. Your inside linebackers will be Matt Leese and Bryce Abbott. Free safety, Ross Pearson. And your corners, a 6', 154-pound sophomore, Jerry Plummer, and a 5'8", 126-pound sophomore, Kelton Paul Powell.
That's going to wrap up the Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance pregame show here on WROI. The kick is right now at Rochester High School. The Zebras won the toss, have elected to defer, which means the Peru Tigers will get the football first, going to our right. Back deep is going to be senior Jeff Clauser for the Peru Tigers. And kicking off for the Rochester Zebras is Zane Duff, kicking into the sun. Beautiful night here at Barnhart Field, week three, and game number one of the TRC conference, or the TRC, here at Rochester High School.
And have we mentioned Peru's defending TRC
we
champions?
We have.
They won the conference in their first season.
Yep. Nice end-over-end kick. Goes over the head of Clauser into the end zone. Touchback Zebras. The Tigers will start at the 20-yard line. Nice kick by Zane Duff. Yep.
Yeah, great job. That's the first time we've seen that go in the end zone
yep.
for Rochester this year.
Light wind out of the east, northeast.
So we've probably played Peru in sectional matchups over the years.
We have.
You have to wonder. It's probably been a long time since Peru's played at Rochester, and definitely the first time for this group of kids.
I remember playing Rochester when Brandon Jones was a, I'm sorry, remember playing Peru when Brandon Jones was a senior. Of course, he went to Peru and
yeah.
played football.
Right.
That kid was amazing. Went for like 250 yards rushing, never scored.
Yeah.
Cunningham under center. I'm sorry, in the shotgun formation. Hands it off to Rader. Rader off the right side. Now back towards the middle at the 35 and pushing the pile ahead to about the 39-yard line. Actually, they're going to whistle him down at the 35-yard line to give him 15 yards. And that was Jordan Rader, a junior for the Peru Tigers, who picked up 15 in the first play from scrimmage.
Yeah, he never did get tackled. He had a host of Zebras holding him up, but they never did get him off his feet.
So the Peru Tigers run out of the shotgun formation with a fullback of Seifel to the left of the quarterback. Now to the to the left this side of two halfbacks on the near side.
Yeah, we got motion.
And now we're going to have a penalty on the play. It's either going to be offsides or it's going to be.
I think a Peru player jumped.
Yeah, but Peru's
get,
cheering. I think
yeah.
it's going to be in the neutral zone infraction on the Zebras.
He's
going to mark him off five. Travis Watring just sent me a text and said Peru played at Rochester his senior year. Of course,
okay.
that doesn't tell me
what year that was. Nobody knows when that was.
Yeah, that's right. 2010. Thank
okay.
you, Matt. First and five for the Tigers at the 45-yard line of Peru. Here's a snap on the end around. Ball goes to Giesen. Giesen down the left side. Giesen in Rochester territory at the 30, at the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Tigers. No flag. No flag. A 65-yard run by Gavin Giesen, and the Tigers strike first.
Yeah, two plays, 80 yards for Peru, and as Giesen flips out of that backfield and runs 65 yards, and if he was touched, it wasn't much more than just a brush on the hip by anybody from Rochester.
And so Peru lined up to go for the extra point, leading 6-0. Here, 30 seconds gone in the opening quarter. Snap is back, hold is down, kick is away. It's a short kick, and it goes wide right. No good. 6-0 Peru. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Well, it didn't take him long, Bradley. 30 seconds into the game, Rochester down already 6-0 to the Peru Tigers after Giesen scored on a 65-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, just kind of a little counterplay. Of course, they got three backs and a quarterback all within 3 yards of the line of scrimmage, and it's kind of not a little more than kind of. It's really tough to see who's got the football.
That time, Giesen came from his right half-pass position, took the ball going left, and it was wide open.
Yep, they make the fake to... fake the Raider who came straight ahead and give off on that little counter back to the left, and Giesen untouched 65 yards.
Isaac Jackson and also Wood back deep for the Rochester Zebras. I believe that's Wood, or is that Dalton? It is Dalton. Wilson Dalton back deep. So here's the kick, short end over end kick, and it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, so the flag will come out. Peru will either kick it off again, or they'll march it off for Rochester to start at about their own 40. We'll see what the call is going to be here from the officials. They're talking to Coach Grant now on the sideline. Rochester's offense will come out with Ross Pearson under center for the Zebras in week three. He took over the quarterback position last week after Brady Perez got injured. So,
and Rochester's going to make them
kick it again. Yeah, Peru trying to kick it short and to one of the up men, and went out of bounds. So they'll do it again. Coach Grant going to make them kick it again.
So again, Isaac Jackson, who is a freshman, runs the C team quarterbacking position for the Rochester Zebras back deep, along with Wilson Dalton, stands inside their 15-yard line. And now they both creep up into inside their 20. Austin Caldwell, junior kicker, will kick for the – no, I beg your pardon, Jason Kepner will kick for the Peru Tigers, who lead 6-0 here at Rochester High School. This one's not going to go out of bounds in the middle of the field, taken by the up man at the 30, the 35, and there's a tackle about the 37-yard line.
Jacob Good for Rochester on the return.
And so
Rochester are going to end up with just about where they would have if they just taken the penalty.
Well, who would have known? You know,
their own 36.
It just takes that one time to break through and pop it and go.
So Rochester quickly to the football.
Pearson in the pistol formation. Bryce Abbott behind him. Wood and Davis wide to the near side. Wood goes in motion to the right side. On the option, Bryce Abbott right up the middle. He takes it to the 39-yard line. It'll be a pickup of about 3. It'll be second down and 7 for the Rochester Zebras. Plummer brings the play in from the sideline. Jerry Plummer.
Yep, Wood going in motion on that last play. You can see just a little bit of a hitch in his as he was trotting to the opposite side of the field. That ankle probably going to bother him more and more as the game goes on.
Four wide outs for Rochester. Two to the near, two to the far. Wood in motion going to the right. On the option play, Bryce Abbott right up the middle again. Bryce looking to the 41-yard line. I believe he's going to get the spot, give him 2 yards, and bring up third down and 5 for the Z's. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Peru leading here at Rochester High School, 6-0 after a 65-yard touchdown run by Giesen. The extra point was missed.
Of course, I know that Rochester's dealing with their backup quarterback right now, but it really would be nice to see if they can get some sort of a passing game, even just a short passes out to the flats, just to try and free up Abbott a little bit in the middle.
On the option, Ross Pearson around the near side. He's got a first down, but there's a flag on the play as he is tackled at the Peru 46-yard line. No, make that the 49-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. He's shy from going into Peru territory. Peru says it's against Rochester. And we'll wait and see what the call is. I believe it's going to be a hold on the Rochester Zebras, which will bounce them back about 10 yards.
Yeah, and you know the hold comes about a yard downfield, so it's going to end up costing them nine.
So the ball now back at the Rochester 31-yard line. Bring up third and about 15 for the Rochester Zebras. Dalton and Jackson go wide to the right side. Davis and Wood wide to the near side out of the pistol formation. Here's Pearson. Here's the snap. Pearson rolling right, throwing right. He's got Dalton down the near far sideline, and it's just overthrown. Wow. It'll be incomplete, and it'll bring up fourth and 15.
I like the call. He had Dalton wide open with the defender behind him, and Pearson just, you know, a little high, a little wobbly on the pass, but you got the wind behind you.
Yep.
And you throw a deep pass like that to the flat. I like the call.
So that's going to bring on Zane Duff, junior kicker for the Rochester Zebras. Back deep is Geeson to receive the punt. High snap, right in the sun. Duff gets it off, and it goes out of bounds. Probably going to be out of bounds right close to midfield. We'll see where they mark that.
Peru 45.
How would you like to be the punter there? As that snap is high, and you could see the sun in the face of Duff, and I was impressed he was able to catch it.
Yeah,
no, he didn't see it.
Yeah, you're right. It was high. It was just off his fingertips when he caught it. But you're right, yeah, looking right into it, the sun there.
So they're going to spot the ball for the Tigers at their own 46-yard line, going to our right. Cunningham brings the club to the line of scrimmage. He'll work out of the shotgun formation. To his left is Raider. Two halfbacks to the near side. Here's a snap. Raider gets the carry right up the middle. Follows his block. Second ever. Pops into the outside. And Raider is
brought down
at about the 45-yard line of the Rochester Zebras. So he's going to pick up about 9 yards and bring up second down and one for the Tigers. 9:50 to play in the first quarter. Peru leading 6-0, and they are quickly on the ball. Raider to the left of Cunningham, who's in the shotgun formation.
There's that counter again.
Geeson again off the left side. Geeson has the first down, still turning the legs, still chopping the feet, and he takes it to the Rochester 31-yard line. And that'll be another Tiger first down as they're deep into Rochester territory once again.
14 yards on the pickup that time by Geeson. On the same play he scored on,
yep,
on the last
right
series. And he was maybe one man away from scoring on that one.
Tigers on the ball. Here's a snap. The fullback Raider off the right side. He's got a huge hole. Pops it to the outside. Gives a forearm to, or a stiff arm, I should say, to Pearson. And he carries the football inside the Rochester 15 near the 10. And that'll be another first down of about 20 yards for Geeson. And already Geeson has, what, three carries for close to 100?
That was Raider, though. That's
that was Raider. Okay.
Yep. He had 21 on that one. He's got 45 on three carries.
First and goal from the 9 for the Tigers. Cunningham out of the shotgun. Gives to Raider again, right side. Raider looking for the end zone. Stacked up at the 1 and driven backwards. It'll be short of the goal line of about a yard and a half. It'll be second down and goal.
Ross Pearson,
about the 2.
Pearson and Bryce Abbott on the stop for Rochester.
Second down and goal from the 2. 9:10 to play in the first quarter. Quickly, the Tigers on the ball. Raider going right again. Stood up at the goal line. Still pushing the pile ahead. No signal yet from the official. There it is. Touchdown, Rochester, on a 2-yard run by Jordan Raider.
All the Peru players were motioning for the touchdown, but it took a while for the officials to concur. That time, Raider does the bulk of the work, and he gets that 2-yard plunge.
9:04 to play in the first quarter. The Tigers up 12-0, and they'll bring on the extra point team. Kind of seen this offset play where most of the kids are all the way over on the other side. And they're going to go for 2. They throw it in the end zone. Wide open receiver. It is good. The 2-point conversion is good. Tigers lead 14-0. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI. Back at Rochester High School, the Peru Tigers on the board again, this time after a two-yard run by the fullback, Jordan Rader. The two-point conversion was good. It's now 14-0.
Yeah, they lined up, like you said, in that offset play where it's just the center and the kicker and the holder, and everybody else is off to the one side of the field. They shot a receiver down to the open side of the field. Rochester was slow to react on defense, wide open in the end zone for the two-point conversion.
Dalton and Jackson back deep. Rissner, one of the up men, along with Abbott. Short kick. Checks up at the Rochester 36-yard line. Makes that the
34.
Makes that 33 now, and that's where Rochester will start this possession. And that ball just about went out of bounds again.
Yeah. Peru, five plays, 54 yards. And Rader with the two-yard touchdown and then the two-point conversion.
Yeah. Wide open was the receiver
in
that two-point conversion.
Yeah, I think it may have been the first time a lot of these players for Rochester's ever seen a play like that line up for the extra point, and they just a little unsure of their defensive assignment.
I agree. North Miami leads Tippecanoe Valley right now, 7-0, thanks to Val. Out of the pistol, Pearson on the option, takes it, runs, and is going to be stopped for a loss. And he's going to be stopped for about a three-yard loss. That'll bring up a second down and 13.
That's pushing it to say Pearson runs. I think he got about a step and a half in before he was met by the defensive tackle by Peru.
Hamilton Heights leads Lewis Cass 7-0 in the first quarter. Second and 13 for the Zebras. Out of the pistol. Pearson with Abbott behind him. Here's a snap. On the option, runs right, pitches out to Wood. Wood still looking to get back to the line of scrimmage and just does. A great athletic effort by Wood. And Pearson going to the ground, got it out to Wood. And, boy, the Zebras lucky to even hang on to that football.
Pearson just kind of scooped that ball out just half a second before his knees hit the ground, and Wood was lucky to grab a hold of it just above his shoestrings. But
that's the second play in a row that the Peru Tiger front four or five have been in the backfield.
You're right. Again, a situation where, you know, everybody for Rochester is playing on both sides of the football, and it's starting to take an effect.
Third and five, make that third and 12 for the Z. Jackson gets the carry coming to the near side, and he's going to be dropped for a loss. Jackson is stopped back at his own 27-yard line, and Coach Grant not very happy with someone wearing a black and gold jersey. He's out in the, and I think he's going to use a timeout, and he's going to crawl into somebody's helmet. We'll take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Back at Rochester High School. After the timeout, Rochester punts. Geeson muffed it, but picked it up. And then it shakes the tackler, loses the football, ball loose, and falls on it. Ball still loose.
Yep.
Ball still on the ground. And
Peru did get it.
Fall on it, yep.
So Geeson started at his own 38, got it up to about the 45, and then ended up back at the 35.
So Peru will start this drive after Rochester's three and out. And they'll start here at their own, 34-yard line, going to our right, ball in the near hash. 14-0, Peru with 7:12 to play in the first quarter here at Rochester High School.
Peru's run a total of seven offensive plays and have scored twice. So Rochester's defense still struggling with that really tight, compact offensive lineup for Peru.
So out of the shotgun, Cunningham brings him to the line of scrimmage. To his left is the fullback Raider, two halfbacks to the near side. Here's a snap. Geeson gets it going left. Geeson still on his feet, pops into the Rochester sideline. Now back towards the middle, runs over Plummer, and Plummer holds on as he's going to his back and brings down Geeson at the Rochester 41-yard line.
27-yard pickup by Geeson.
And quickly, the Tigers on the football. Near hash, out of the shotgun is Cunningham. Fakes to Raider, keeps it right up the middle. Cunningham at the 30, falls ahead to the Rochester 28, and at the end of the play, there's a flag.
And they have an inadvertent face mask.
We'll get this all sorted out. It looks like it will be against the Rochester Zebras. It is a face mask. They'll tack some on to that 12 or 13-yard gain there by the quarterback Cunningham.
5 yards on top of the 12 that Cunningham gained.
So now it's first and 10 for the Tigers at the Rochester 23. Out of the shotgun is Cunningham. Takes the snap, gives to Raider. Raider picking his way through the traffic on a burst of speed. Gets it inside the 20, down to around the 15-yard line. So he's going to pick up 8. It'll bring up second down and 2 for the Tigers. And then back quickly on the football, I think. There's a lot of folks that took notice of what John Glenn did to the Rochester Zebras in week one.
I agree.
Quick no huddle.
Yeah, with everybody going both ways.
Back to pass. Is Cunningham has a wide open receiver. Is incomplete. I mean wide open.
Yeah.
Wide open receiver in the back of the end zone is incomplete. And that was intended for one of the tight ends, Austin Strong, for the Peru Tigers. Will bring up 3rd and 2.
Coach Prescott talked in the pregame about how they're, you know, they're not going to rely on their passing game. They've not been very successful with it. Matter of fact, he was 0-8 last week in the win against Northfield.
Yeah, I guess that was only to keep you honest kind of pass.
Yeah, I
right
guess
there,
so, yeah. Well, and the receiver was open, so
second
you got to keep trying.
Raider spins away from one tackler, but not all of them, and he has stopped right there at the line of scrimmage. In fact, he's driven right to the line of scrimmage. It'll be 4th and 2. Got a good job by the Rochester Zebras.
Wilson Dalton, the first one on the scene for Rochester.
Matt Lee's also there for the Z's. It'll bring up 4th and 2 for the Tigers at the Rochester 14-yard line.
Well, with the exception of the incomplete pass, that was the first play that Peru didn't gain anything.
Quarterback keeper off the right side. He's spun down. He's going to have enough for a first down as Cunningham gets to the Rochester 11. Giving 4, it'll be first down for the Tigers. And quickly, the Peru Tigers on the football already leading 14-0 with 5:52 to play in the first quarter. Cunningham takes the snap. Actually, it was a
direct snap.
Direct snap to Seibel. And Seibel takes it to the Rochester 5. It'll be 2nd down and about 4 after a 6-yard run by Isaac Seibel. I think that's the first time he's carried the ball tonight.
Yep,
that was a direct snap to him. 2nd and 4. Raider off the right side. Raider pushing the Zebras towards his goal line. Still on his feet. Still looking to push it in. And he's going to be whistled down at the 1. So it'll bring up 3rd and 1. Nope, it'll be 1st and goal from the 1 for the Rochester Zebras after a pickup of about 6.
For the Peru Tigers.
Yep, for the Tigers. I'm sorry.
That's one thing that this Peru offensive line, you'll notice, when Raider or Geeson gets the ball, they aren't standing and watching after they throw a block. They're helping push the whole pile forward.
Cunningham, a keeper, going right. Hitting from behind, and he's pushed in. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nope, Peru.
Gosh. Touchdown, Peru. Robert Cunningham.
Yep, Cunningham on the 1-yard keeper for Peru.
With 4:59 to play in the first quarter, and they're lined up exactly they were on the two-point conversion
this last time. Rochester's doing a much better job covering the receivers and playing, lining up defensively.
So now though we'll line up to kick. Snap is back, hold us down, kick is away, and it is good. 21-0, Peru. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI. back at Rochester High School. Well, it took the Tigers a little longer this time, but they did stuff it in for six more. Now they're up 21-0.
Yeah, nine plays, 66 yards, and this time it was the one-yard quarterback keeper by Cunningham. And we got to see, you know, at least attempt the pass on that series. It wasn't all running. But once again, Rochester, I tell you what, that Peru offensive line, they just do a great job of opening holes for Giesen and Raiders. And now Cunningham starting to get into act a little bit, the quarterback.
So Peru will kick Dalton and Jackson back deep for the Zebras.
North Miami 14-0 over Tippecanoe Valley in the first quarter.
End over end kick. Jackson picks it up at the 17-yard line, at the 20, dodges one tackler, and his knee comes down about the 25-yard line, so we'll see exactly where we're going to have that.
So far, the first two possessions, Rochester four plays and punt, four plays and punt.
So the Zs will start here on their own 25-yard line, ball in the near hash. Manchester leads 7-0 after the first quarter. We have who they're playing?
Wabash.
Okay.
That's kind of, Wabash started off the season 2-0, so. Yeah.
Pearson on the quarterback keeper, stood up right at the line of scrimmage. Not a lot there. Maybe a yard, maybe.
Well, they're going to move the six, so we'll give him one.
Second and nine for Rochester. Bowling out their own 26-yard line. Clock rolls, 4.5 minutes to play in the first quarter with the Peru Tigers leading 21-0.
Mother scores real quick. Northfield leads Southwood 7-0. Witco 14-0 over McConaughey. And Hamilton Heights 7-0 over Lewis Cass.
Bryce Abbott off the right side. He got away from a couple of Tigers up front, but...
Yeah, a lot of white jerseys in the backfield for
linebackers
for Abbott.
Flying to the ball, and he only picked up a yard. It'll be third and eight for the Zebras. Now the 27.
Well, I think until Rochester can establish some kind of passing game, it's just going to be Katie Bartador send everybody.
Yeah.
There's no reason to have a safety playing 20 yards back if you're not going to challenge him.
You know, what's that old saying? Beat us with the pass?
Yeah.
Four wideouts, two to the near, two to the far for Rochester. Ball in the middle of the field on third and eight. Pearson fakes the handoff, runs to the near side. Pearson at the 30. Caught from behind, drugged down at about the 32-yard line. He'll be short of a first down of about 2 yards to give him six. It'll be fourth and two for the Rochester Zebras. And down 21-0, they're going to go for it. Fourth down and two for the Rochester Zebras at their own 33-yard line. And Rochester jumps off sides. It'll be false start on the Zs.
And now he's calling for the punt team.
I think so.
Yep.
So Rochester jumps. It'll back him up five. And that'll be fourth down and seven. And Duff back on to kick this one away for Rochester. Matt Thomas, I'm David Muslim. I think the way it looked to me, all Ross wanted to do was
see if he could draw Peru off.
Yeah, and he almost did that.
Yeah.
Instead, he made his own guy jump as well. So Duff back inside his 15. High snap over the head of Duff. It bounces up to him, one hop. Duff's going to run. Buff cuts it inside, and then Peru right there to meet him at the 15. So a high snap. Rochester going to turn it over on downs, and the Tigers will take it first and 10 at the Rochester 15-yard line.
Actually, they're going to mark it at the 14.
Okay. Winamac leads Culver 14-0 in the first quarter.
Zane Duff only 5'8", and that ball was snapped at
that
about...
That was my head.
That was, snapped at about 10'2".
First and 10 for the Tigers at the Zebra 14-yard line, already up 21-0, under three to play in the first quarter. Cunningham brings the club to the line of scrimmage. He'll be in the shotgun formation with Raider to his left. Here's a direct snap to the up man, Seibel. And Seibel goes to the left. Cut down to the 10, maybe the 9. Give him about 4. He'll be second down and 6. 2:45 to play in the first quarter. And Peru quickly on the ball again. Entire offense standing up, looking at the sideline, now has the play and ready to go. Cunningham ready. To his left is Rader, to his right is Seibel. The wing back to the all the way to the right side is Giesen. Here's the snap. Giesen takes it going left on the counter. Giesen lowers his head, pushes the pile ahead, maybe to the six-yard line. And it'll be short of a first down. It'll be third down and about one for the Peru Tigers, just shy of the Rochester five.
Giesen averaging just a little over 25 yards every time he touches the football. Four carries and 110 yards.
Mr. Sunshine.
Yeah.
Third down and two.
Depends on what side of the field he's sitting on.
Out of the shotgun, Cunningham takes a snap, hands to Rader. Rader going right, pushing the head pile ahead, looking for the end zone touchdown. Tigers, and there's a flag after the play.
Yep.
It's a six-yard touchdown run.
That'll be against Rochester, unsportsmanlike.
By Rader, but the officials going to the
Peru bench.
Peru bench.
Maybe something got said, I don't know. I thought there was a lot of pushing and hitting after the whistle blew in.
Touchdown.
Unsportsmanlike against Peru. So the touchdown counts, and then afterwards, Peru's going to get called for an unsportsmanlike. So they'll be kicking from about their own 20.
1:43 to play in the first quarter. It's now 27-0 with the extra point coming. Rochester expecting the two-point conversion. Peru sees it. Now everybody back on the line of scrimmage, and we're going to kick the football this time. Snap is back, hold is down, kick is away, and it is good. 28-0 Peru. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Back at Rochester High School, Jordan Rader scores his second touchdown of the night from 6 yards out, and the Tigers are up now 28-0.
Yeah, that one just took three plays, went 14 yards after the high snap on the punt by Rochester, and Rader gets his second touchdown of the night.
1:43 to play in the first quarter. Brad, some scores from around the area?
Yeah, Winnemac leads Culver 6-0. North Miami leads Tippecanoe Valley 14-6. Manchester over Wabash 7-0 early. That would be an upset. Northfield over Southwood 7-0. Also, I think, an upset because Southwood was undefeated going into tonight. Whitco over McConaughey 14-0. Hamilton Heights 7-0 over Lewis Cass. And Plymouth leads Warsaw 7-0. I see where Plymouth dropped number 7 in the coaches' poll this week. I think that's going to be a short plummet. I think they're going to rise up the charts. They're ranked number 1 in Class 4A in the computer ranking, but the coaches haven't come around yet.
So we're going to kick this time. It's obviously 15 yards back.
Next week, opponent is Whitco. They now lead 22-0 over McConaughey.
Yay. So the Peru are going to kick this thing at the 20-yard line, their own 20.
Yeah.
And the way the kickoffs have been going, Rochester should start this series in pretty good field position.
Well, yeah. If they kick it like they have so far, it's going to come down about the 50-yard line. So we'll see. Hopefully Rochester can get a return on it.
Dalton, Jackson back deep. They stand at their own 31-yard line. End over end, line drive kick right down the middle of the field. Jackson takes it up the 30-yard line and just falls on it after the muff at the 32. Man, that thing was set up perfectly.
Yeah.
You let him go, and he's going to make some things happen. He's a quick freshman and we just need to field that thing cleanly and run.
The first 2 weeks, Rochester's kicking game was probably one of the only bright spots out of those two ball games. With Corbin Wood back there receiving for Rochester, they had a lot of big returns. Corbin Wood had a 91-yard return last week against Plymouth. And this week, it's totally different.
Yeah.
We haven't had a good return yet.
So Rochester takes over here with a minute 38 to play in the first quarter at their own 33-yard line, going into the sun, down 28 to nothing. Jackson comes in motion to the near side. Back to pass is Pearson. Throws down the near sideline. He's got Wood over his head. Incomplete. And that'll bring up second down and 10.
Another good effort on the pass play. Wood unable to come down with it off the top of the fingertips.
Might have ran out of some real estate as well.
Yeah, it was right along the sideline.
Yep. Second down and 10 for Rochester. Again, ball at the 33-yard line. Going to our left on the near hash. Jackson, Dalton wide to the right side. Wood and Davis split left. Pistol formation for Rochester. Wood in motion to the right side. On the option, Wood gets the pitch from Pearson. Wood at the 40, the 45 at midfield and falls into Peru territory. First and 10 for the Zebras at the 46.
Nice job by Corbin Wood. Pearson did a good job of flipping the ball out to him in front of him in motion. And Corbin Wood did it. He did the rest as he was able to get past the corner there on the side for Peru and pick up some valuable yardage for Rochester.
First and 10 for the Z's at the Peru 47-yard line. Wood in motion to the right on the option. Bryce Abbott takes the football to the 45 of Peru, and that's about it. Giving him two, it'll be second and 8. Northwestern leads Benton Central 14-0. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 55 seconds to play in the first quarter. The Tigers leading 28-0 here at Barnhart Field. Driston brings the play in from the sideline. Z's will break the huddle with about 14 on the play clock. 13 on the play clock. Dalton and Jackson wide to the right side. Driston and Wood wide to the near side. Down to 7 on the play clock. Here's the snap. Bryce Abbott right up the middle. And he is going to be shut down after about maybe a one-yard gain. Well, he didn't get a lot.
Now, those Peru defensive tackles are really doing a good job of collapsing everything inside. And Abbott's having a difficult time finding any kind of hole in there.
Give him one. It'll be third down and 7 for the Zebras. We're down to 11 seconds to play in the first quarter, and Rochester might just let this one run out. After one, the Zebras trail the Tigers 28-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Yep. Back at Rochester High School, we're going to the second quarter. The Zebras trailing the Peru Tigers 28-0. And as we start the third, Brad, Rochester looking at about third down and 7, third down and a short 8. But Peru is winning the war up front. They are controlling the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, you're right. Offensively, they've scored on all four of their possessions in the first quarter. And the last possession they had, we set them up from the 14-yard line, but they've scored from their own 20 and went the entire distance. So, and defensively, they're doing a great job of shutting down the interior of Rochester's offensive line. Bryce Abbott having a heck of a time finding any opening.
Wood in motion to the near side. Back to pass is Pearson. Pearson pumps, runs away from some Tigers, but not all of them, and he's sacked back at his 48-yard line. So that'll bring up fourth down and about 16 yards for the Rochester Zebras. And on comes Zane Duff again for the Z's. And the dangerous Geeson, Gavin Geeson, slides back to receive the punt. Geeson still backpedaled. And he'll come to rest at around his 22-yard line. So Duff will look to get this one away. Had a good punt last time. There's a good snap. No pressure. Duff gets it away off the side of his foot and coming out of bounds. And it goes out of bounds at the Peru 36-yard line.
That's a pretty generous spot from Rochester.
I would say that's probably right.
Yeah. Well, after the first quarter of the third week, Rochester's been outscored 69-0 in the first quarter of their first three games. So that's an average of, you know, roughly 23 points a game in the first quarter. It's pretty tough to ask anybody to dig themselves out of a three-touchdown deficit after this first quarter. Well, North Miami increases their lead 21-6 over Tippecanoe Valley. And I know the North Miami coach was saying it was important for them to get off to a fast start.
Now the quarter, I believe that was Cunningham who took the handoff. I'll have to wait and see. It looked like there was a new quarterback, and it looks like, nope. We got some new faces in the game for Peru. That was Jeff Closser who took the handoff. It looks like your quarterback now is Lucas McConaughey. Gives it on the end around. And McConaughey hands off to Shea Walker, a 5'9 senior for the Tigers. And it's going to bring up third down and about seven for the Tigers at their own 39-yard line, going to our left, which is right into the sun. Again, McConaughey, a 5'11 junior for the Tigers. On the football to his left is Clauser. Fakes a handoff. McConaughey rolls right. The pass is complete on the far side. He's got a first down and drugged down from behind by, I believe, Wilson Dalton. But the pass play takes the Peru Tigers into Rochester territory down to the 48, first and 10 Tigers.
Well, that's a rare completion for Peru. You see who the receiver
I
was?
I did not. 10 minutes to play in the first half. Peru up 28-0. Bible was the receiver for the Tigers. And even though they're on the football, they're taking some time off the play clock. They're down to 15. McConaughey gives the Closser going right. Closser has a huge first down, and he's off the races. And Ross Pearson saves a touchdown, hanging off for dear life, and brings him down at the 30-yard line. Another huge run by the tailback for the Peru Tigers, and this time it was Closser. He takes it to the Rochester 30, first and 10.
An 18-yard gain by Closser.
First and 10 for the Tigers at the Rochester 30-yard line. They're going to our left. Taking some time here off the play clock. As McConaughey brings the club to the line of scrimmage, Closser to his left at the fullback position. Here's a snap on the end around. The running back Walker is stood up in the backfield and driven backwards. But they're going to give him his forward progress back at the line of scrimmage. It'll be a pickup of nothing. It'll be second and 10. Clock rolls here at Barnhart Field. 9 minutes to play, first half. The Tigers leading 28-0. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Second and 10 for the Tigers. Now to 18 on the play clock. McConaughey in the shotgun formation. Closer to his left. Here's a snap. Walker again off to the left side. Walker using his blockers up front and pushes the pile ahead to about the 26.
Gilbreth on the stop for Rochester.
So it'll be third down and 6 now for the Tigers after a 4-yard run by Walker, the backup tailback, halfback for the Tigers. 8:23 to play here in the first half. McConaughey in the shotgun formation. Down to 12 on the play clock. Third and six for the Tigers. Lost to the fullback right at the middle. And he's tackled shy of the 20-yard line. Going to pick up 3 yards. It'll bring up third down and about three. I'm sorry, fourth down and about three.
The first fourth down Peru's face tonight.
Manchester leads with 5.5 to play in the first half, 7-6. Fourth and three for the Tigers. McConaughey in the shotgun formation. Down to 12 on the play clock. He sets the line of scrimmage, takes a snap, gives the Closter going right. Closter's got a first down, pushing the pile ahead. Gets near the Rochester 15. Maybe they're going to mark him at the 16. Regardless, it's going to be another Tiger first down.
Closter that time just got in behind his big offensive line. And they didn't really create a hole so much as they created a wedge. And he just stayed in the middle.
Yeah, I agree with that. Give him the 16. First and 10 for the Tigers. 7:20 to play in the first half. They lead 28-0. McConaughey quickly to the line of scrimmage. Down to 12 on the play clock. He's ready out of the shotgun. Fakes the handoff right up the middle. McConaughey looking for the end zone. He's stretching
really
for the goal
close.
Line. And he's going to be cut down just shy. Giving the one. It'll be a pickup of about 15 yards and first and goal from about the 1 yard line for the Tigers.
McConaughey on the keeper brought down just short of the goal line.
That almost looked like a busted play as McConaughey looked like he maybe wanted to hand off, but the back had already left. He just kind of tucked it and found a hole.
First and goal from about the 2 for the Tigers. McConaughey, Closter. Right side, touchdown, Peru. Jeff Closter, a 2-yard run for the Tigers, who now lead 34-0.
Well, that time we saw a bunch of new faces in the backfield for Peru, but it resulted in the same
yep.
result as the others. Another touchdown.
6:39 to play in the second quarter. It's 34-0, and the extra point coming for the Tigers.
That time Peru sneaking a receiver in just off the sideline. Rochester picks it up.
Kick is away and looks good. It is good. 35-0. Peru will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football 92.1 WROI and RTC TV 4. The Tigers strike again with basically their second string, Bradley. It's now 35-0.
Yeah, 10 plays, 64 yards after a short punt by Rochester.
And you know, I shouldn't say second string because I don't know what the line of scrimmage is doing, but I know the skilled players right now are second string.
What we know is the starters didn't play that series,
yeah.
to put it that way. So the next group in comes in. You know, Coach Prescott has talked about his passing game not being something that they rely on, and yet when they get the second quarterback in there, McConaughey, first thing he does is complete a 13-yard pass to Seibel, and that sparks them down the field. From there, they continue to run that mixed direction from the backfield and chip away at it. They did face a fourth down that time. I think that's the first time tonight that Rochester forced them into a fourth down situation, but they answered with about a 7-yard gain and went on to put it in the end zone.
Makes it 35-0, Peru, and they're off to kick it again. Looks like Riston now Wood or maybe Dalton back deep for the Zebras. Low line drive kick taken by the up man. And that's Dalton, I believe, the up man. And Dalton returns it out to the 34. Give that man the ball.
Yeah.
So first and 10 for the Z's. They'll start this series at their own 33 going to our right. Quickly, Rochester on the football. Dalton and Jackson wide to the near side. Davis and Wood split left. Ross Pearson in the shotgun formation, yeah, with Abbott behind him. Wood comes in motion to the near side. Here's the snap on the option. Wood makes that. Abbott gets it right up the middle. And Abbott falls ahead to the 35, maybe two on the play. Give him one. It'll be second down and nine.
Wood needs to be careful when he turns that up. He doesn't do it before the ball snaps.
Yeah.
He probably got away with one on that one.
Do you really think they're going to call that?
You never know.
Second down, and we'll say eight. Two receivers for Rochester. I mean, make that four receivers. Two to the near, two to the far. Jackson goes in motion left. On the option, Pearson's going to take it. Rice right up the middle. Hit to the 36, falls ahead, maybe to the 37.
There were three people from Peru just standing and waiting on Ross Pearson to come around.
Without a black helmet on him.
Well, yeah. Just the fact that because Rochester's passing game really hasn't clicked, they're only looking at two people.
Yep.
And that's, you know, Pearson and Abbott.
Ross Pearson picks up 2 yards. You got to bring him third down and six.
You had three people biting on Abbott when he got the fake, and you had the other three waiting on Pearson.
Yep.
Yeah.
Felton Powell in the game for the first time tonight. He goes split to the left side. On third and six, Wood in motion to the near side. Fake the handoff. Pearson's going to take it, going left, and he's going to be dropped for a loss. Ooh. Back at the 41-yard line.
You know, you hate. Pearson's probably thinking, why you blew the whistle? I broke free and had a good pickup. But, boy, you about have to call the whistle on that or somebody's going to get a broken ankle out of that.
I beg your pardon. That play, I believe, started at about the 46, not the 36, the 46. And Rochester's pushed back to the 42-yard line. It'll bring up fourth down in about 11. And the way it looks from here, Rochester will go for it. Down 35 to nothing with 4.5 minutes to play in the first half. And Rochester's going to have to use a timeout. We'll take a 60. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Back here at Rochester High School, 4:28 to play in the first half. Zebras looking at fourth down and about 11 at their own 42-yard line will go for it, down 35 to nothing. Pearson in the pistol, Abbott behind him. Wood comes in motion to the near side. Here's the snap, back to pass to Pearson, and actually he's going to kick it. Nice kick.
Yeah.
Well, Pearson then gets a Rochester bounce, goes out of bounds.
Yep.
Right around the 27-yard line. I like that.
Yeah, I don't know that Pearson...
That rugby-style kick?
Yeah, and I don't know that he ever had control of the football. He was bobbling it right up to the point that he kicked it. So, good job.
At halftime, Caston leads West Central 6-0. So, Peru will have it first and 10 at their own 27, up 35 to nothing, going to our left, ball and be in the near hash.
And they have scored on every possession.
Yeah, you're right.
From running it. They've had four different players score tonight.
They've completed one pass.
Yep.
Well, the second pass was completed for a two-point conversion, but one pass. And
no huddle, straight to the line of scrimmage.
Looks like the starters will come back. That's Cunningham down in the backfield. But he hands off to Klosser again. Klosser up, picks his way through the traffic. On the second and third effort, gets him across the 30 to around the 32. Let's give him five. It'll be second down and five for the Tigers. With 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Just another instance where, you know, Rochester without the depth and the other team bringing in platoons of players.
Dylan Weaver in the game, playing D-line. Right defensive tackle right now for the Z's. Actually, they're going to give him six, so it'll be second down and four for the Tigers. Peru taking some time off the play clock. Cunningham ready. Nope, that's going to be McConaughey. McConaughey shovels a pass ahead to Walker, and Walker takes the ball close to the 40-yard line. They're going to give him the 39, but it is enough for another Tiger first down. I saw the four. I thought it was a two, but it's an eight. So that's McConaughey still out there for the Tigers. First and 10 for Peru at their own 39-yard line. 3:25 to play in the first half. Again, the Tigers leading 35 to nothing. McConaughey with Foster to his left. Sets the club. Takes the snap, fakes the handoff. He'll keep it right up the middle. McConaughey crosses the 40, gets to the 42-ish. Second down after about a 3-yard gain. Second down and 7 for the Tigers. All they want to do is get out of here at halftime. The week that was coming up here at the break, and there was a lot of it. Got some middle school cross-country results for the first time since we've been doing the week that was. Yeah. Now if I get all the names right. Second and 7, McConaughey.
So you're saying there's going to be a lot of Bob Smith?
Oh, yeah. Direct snap to the front man, Seibel. And Seibel, there's a flag in the play, and Rochester Church at the 40, cuts back, backs his way to about the 37-yard line. That's going to be a first down for the Tigers for now, but let's see what the flag is all about.
We could have a holding against Peru. And we do. We're going to have holding.
So that'll negate the big run by Seibel. We're going to have a block in the back by the Tigers. That'll back him up. Where were they going to spot
that? That'll block him, back him up to the Peru 35 on the spot of the foul.
Yeah, good call. So that'll bring up second down and about. Yeah.
If he can count 10
14.
Yards. Yep.
Hamilton Heights leads Lewis Cass 14-6 with time running out in that first half. Second 14 now for Rochester. I'm sorry, for Peru. Back to their own 35-yard line. 3:26 to play.
I could very well see him run the same play.
Why not?
Walker gained, a little over 20 yards on the first time he ran it. That's what they need for a first down. So.
Entire offense looking to the sideline. Has the offensive play. We're down to 12 on the play clock. McConaughey ready. Direct snap to Seibel. It's the same exact play. Seibel kicks it out from the outside and is brought down from behind by Anthony Tinsman.
Tinsman
brings him down. Picked up about 10 yards. I'll bring up third down at about 4. For the Peru Tigers. Ball spotted just shy of their own 45, maybe the 44, 100 seconds to play in the first half.
We'll see if they'll run that counter. It seems to be a repertoire of about 6 plays.
Yeah, it's all work.
And it's all work, you're right.
McConaughey with 8 on the play clock, takes the snap, gives the Closter going right. Closter pushing the pile ahead, takes it to his own 47-yard line. It'll be fourth and about 1 for the Tigers. Going to get about the 48 and a half. A minute to play. First and a long 1 for the Tigers. They're on 47. Clock under a minute to go in the first half. Again, Peru up 35 to nothing. McConaughey to Walker on the counter. Walker's got a first down. And Walker takes it into Rochester territory, down to the Rochester 47. And that'll move the stick. And Peru, if they wanted to, could probably just kneel on this thing here for the next 2 plays and call it a half.
The play clock has started. Get one.
Conahay at the line of scrimmage. Down to 33 on the game clock. Here's the snap. Walker again off the left. Walker gets a couple of blocks. Brought down inside the Rochester 40 to the 36 or 7. That'll be enough for another Tiger first down with 22 seconds to play in the first half. The Tigers leading 35-0, and the clock rolls. And that might just do it for halftime, for the first half anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Peru not content to get on the ball and run it, and that'll do it. At halftime, the Peru Tigers lead the Rochester Zebras here at Barney, 35-0. First half stats and the week that was coming up next. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC-TV4. Back at Rochester High School, we're a minute or so away from getting the second half underway at Barnhart Field. Right now, the Peru Tigers lead the Zebras 35-0, and Brad, you have some scores from around the area.
Yes, Caston leads West Central 6-0. Winamac over Culver 6-0. North Miami and Tippecanoe Valley are at halftime 35-6. North Miami leads that. Wabash 12-7 over Manchester. Northfield led Southwood at last report 7-0. Witco leads Mechanicwal. That's who Rochester has next week, Witco. 28-0. Hamilton Heights 14, Lewis Cass 6. Plymouth led Warsaw 7-0 after the first quarter. And Pioneer leading Triton 29-0. Pioneer
keep rolling.
They're going to be back in the state finals again this year with a new coach.
Right.
This is a first-year coach for them.
However, the guy that's the head coach this time, right now, played under Mike Johnson.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
How long was Mike Johnson at Pioneers? That had to be 20 years, wasn't it?
Did he? 60 years?
Maybe not that long.
What it feels
20,
like.
25 years anyway.
Yeah.
And he just kept winning.
All he did was win.
Yeah.
At a 1A school that size, all he did was win.
Even against the likes of Winamac.
Yeah.
With the teams they've had in the last 5 or 6 years, So great job down there at Pioneer High School. They definitely Mike Johnson did a heck of a job of building a program, and a new coach could just step in and get the same result.
Yeah. Have we heard a Logan Sports score tonight, Val?
I haven't heard a Logan Sports score.
So Rochester won the toss and elected to defer, which means they're going to get the ball first here. And I also see Drew Saylor's warming up on the sideline.
Yeah, well, you know, Rochester, we mentioned it a few times, they need to establish some kind of a passing game to try and open up some avenues for Abbott and Wood. And we saw them throw a couple of passes in that first half. The plays themselves looked good. They just didn't result in anything. And so hopefully maybe if Saylor's can get in the game and loosen that arm up, maybe the Zebras can look downfield a little bit.
And you remember a better opening weekend than what we're going to see tomorrow?
College football?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I was excited about the Stanford-Kansas State game tonight. It's going to be on late, so when I get home from tonight.
You'll need a nap to stay up for that.
Kick my shoes off
and
sit back and watch. Well, I'll be in bed. I'll be in bed with the TV on, but who knows? Maybe I'll see a couple plays.
Brew kicks it off. Better kick and take it by Wood on the run at the 20. Wood right up the middle. Wood at the 40. Bounces out of the 42, and that's where he's going to stop.
Now, that's the kick return team we've seen in the last couple of weeks. And that's good to see Wood back there at supposedly full strength. He looks good anyway running the ball here in the second half.
So Rochester will start this drive at their own 41-yard line, make that 42-yard line, going to the left. Ball in the near hash. Davis and Wood split out to the left. Dalton and Jackson wide right. Wood goes in motion to the right side. Pearson takes the snap. Hands off to Wood on the jet sweep. He's around the right end. Corbin Wood stretches to midfield, and the official on this side says he's going to get to the Peru 49-yard line.
Good run by Wood.
Give him eight. It'll be second and two. So second down and two for Rochester at the 49-yard line of the Tigers. Plummer wide to the near side, out of the pistol formation. It's Pearson. Wood goes in motion to the right. And now we're going to have a false start against the Rochester offensive lineman on the far side. And
probably
I think
a good thing for Pearson, because he turned to the right to hand the ball off, and his back went to the left. So Probably a good thing they had a false start on the offensive line.
Coach Grant is going to take a timeout. We'll take a 60. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV 4. After the timeout, second down and 7 for the Zebras on the option. Ross Pearson reads it, cuts it upfield, grabbed by the shoestring, and falls forward to the Peru 46-yard line. Nice read by the senior Ross Pearson, and he takes it upfield and gets the Zebras a first down.
Yeah, it was a good read. He had the pitch man outside of him, but he saw a seam inside and tucked it and run.
Lafayette Harrison leads Logan Sport 29-0. Thank you for that score.
Yalda.
First and 10 for the Z's at the Peru 46. Pearson in the pistol. Behind him is Bryce Abbott. Wood goes in motion to the right side. On the option, Abbott right up the middle. Bryce Abbott at the 40, at the 35, lowers his head, falls inside the Peru 35. And another first down for the Rochester Zebras.
Great run by the freshman, Abbott. He had Wood in front of him, and he just tucked his head down and hit the hole hard. I don't think contact was made until he got 10 yards downfield.
33-yard line is where this first down play starts. Quickly, Rochester on the ball. Wood takes the snap, cuts it upfield. We've got a flag on the play, and Wood is spun around but keeps his feet, works towards the Peru sideline, and is stopped after about a 7-yard gain, but there's a flag on the play.
And that flag came just about as soon as the ball was snapped. Somebody may have been lined up offside.
Sean Lutz with that score. Thank you, Sean. Still haven't seen the indication yet. It'll be illegal motion on the Rochester Zebras. Going to back them up 5. 10:20 to play. First quarter. Peru leading 35-0. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. The ball back now at the 37-yard line.
Rochester offense doing a really good job this series of moving the football, opening up some holes for Wood and Abbott.
More of an up-paced tempo at this point,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, absolutely.
First and 15 for Rochester, back at the Peru 37. Wood goes in motion right. Here's the snap on the option. Pearson keeps it, shovels it ahead. There's the balls on the floor. On the ground.
Yeah, they could. Like I heard here,
yeah,
in the press box, that could be ruled
too.
A forward pass.
I thought it was shoved forward as well.
Are you going to say that Wood came up with it? Or is it incomplete?
And they're going to say that he did catch the ball and recover the fumble, and the ball is taken inside the Peru 35 to the 34-yard line. So that will bring up third down and about 12 after a 3-yard gain. Second and 12. Here's the snap. The pitch goes to Abbott. Bryce looking for the sideline, trying to get to the edge. Flag in the play, flags all over the place. He might have gotten back to the original line of scrimmage, but like I said, there's 2 or 3 flags laying on the turf. Holding on the Rochester Zebras, going the wrong direction.
Yeah, those flags came out just as soon as the tackle was made.
So that ball's going to be marked off back to the 41.
Well, we saw this in week 1 with Rochester. They had a couple good drives to march the ball down within the 5-yard line, but once they got down towards the goal line, you know, penalties stuffed out scoring opportunities.
Second 20 now for the Rochester Zebras at the Peru 41-yard line. Jackson comes in motion on the near side. And the snap hits Jackson. Back to pass now. Pearson throws it up for grabs, and it's incomplete. Intended for Wood. I'm not sure how Pearson grabbed that football, who was coming down the line of scrimmage on the man in motion.
Almost looked like a direct snap to Jackson, except I don't think it was supposed to be.
Jackson wears number 7. The ball hit him on 7 on his back. Deflected to Ross Pearson, who kept his wits about him, grabbed the football, and was still able to get it downfield. Incomplete, but that could have been disastrous for the Zebras.
He had two receivers down there, Davis short and Woods long, and it was over Davis's head, and Woods came back and made a diving attempt to catch it. Fell incomplete.
Third down and 9, and I believe Coach Grant's going to use another timeout. We're down to 5 on the play clock, and he'll do that. We'll take a 60. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. On third down at 20, Pearson lost it up down the far sideline. It's complete to Dalton right there at the stick. Is that going to be a 20 or a 21-yard gain? It's going to be a 21-yard pass play from Pearson to Dalton, and it's a first down for the Z.
And he threw that under pressure. Pearson had somebody.
He stood right in there and took it, though.
He took the hit just as he let go of the football. But he gets the completion, his first one, to Dalton for the first down.
First and 10 for the Zebras at the Peru 21-yard line. 21 or 20. Yeah, 21-yard line. Ball to the far hash. Pearson in the pistol. Jackson comes in motion to the near side. On the option, Pearson rolls on the near side, and he is hit as he throws it, and it's going to be incomplete. And Pearson getting up slow.
It was kind of looked like early on that they were going to do the option, and then Pearson pulled up to throw. And just as he's being hit, he just kind of chucks it two-handed out in front of him, and it falls incomplete.
I believe Jackson was the intended receiver. He'll bring up second and 10.
Yeah.
8.5 minutes to play in the third. Peru leads 35-0. Kelton Powell comes into the game, brings him play in from the sideline. Rochester still in the huddle with 10 on the play clock. Still in the huddle with 8.
More importantly, Rochester's held the ball this entire third quarter.
Still in the huddle with 5, and Rochester's going to have to use their final timeout. We'll take a 60. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Back at Rochester High School, the Zebras are out of timeouts. They look at second down and 10. They're trailing 35-0, ball at the Peru 21-yard line. After 3, Winnemac leads Culver 14-7. Don't let me forget to talk about the Rochester basketball golf outing coming up October 1st.
Okay.
Third, make that second and 10. Pearson in the pistol. Low snap on the option. Comes to the near side. It's tripped up from behind. and he loses the football. Peru has it, but the officials are going to whistle it down and said his knee was down before the ball was pitched.
Pearson trying to keep the play alive, and it's going to be he's going to be lucky that they're going to call him down, even though he's going to lose 4 yards.
Midway through the third quarter, Hamilton Heights leads Lewis Cass 14-12.
Northfield leads Southwood 14-0. Southwood 2-0 to start the season, but they're trailing here in the second half against Northfield.
Third down and 14.
Val says it's at Southwood, so that must be the case.
What are we doing? We're down to 10 on the play clock.
Yeah, and we're still trying to get the play in.
We're not going to get this one off. It's going to be third and 20 after the penalty. We're down to one, we're down to zero, and that'll do it. There's the flag on delay of game, and it's going to back him up five more.
Brings up fourth down.
No, it'll be third and 20.
Oh, okay. I guess they already know the play, so what? Might as well stay at the line of scrimmage.
Wabash leads Manchester early in the third, 20-7. Third and 20 now for Rochester. 7:48 to play in the third quarter. Peru leading 35-0. Wood goes in motion. Fakes the handoff. Pearson keeps it going left. Shakes one tackler, but not the other two. He takes it inside the 30-yard line to about the 27. It'll be fourth down in about a day and a half for Rochester. Down 35-0 with 7.5 to play in the third quarter.
Day and a half equates to roughly 16, 17 yards. for those anal enough to want to know, like myself.
Foul brings the play in from the sideline. Rochester breaks the huddle with 16 on the play clock. Oh, they're still in the huddle.
Yeah.
We're going to have to hurry. We're down to 10 now. They break the huddle with 8. Rochester with 6, with 5. Sets the line with 4. Wood goes in motion with 3. Here's the snap. Wood gets the handoff. Reverse to Jackson on the near side. Jackson then caught at the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Peru will take over on downs.
Well, they tried to run the double reverse as Wood got the initial handoff from Pearson and then gives it to a little flip to Jackson, but the play took a long time to set up, and Peru was not fooled. But Rochester did manage to run nearly 5 minutes off the clock, 6 minutes off the clock, so Peru with their first opportunity here in the second half.
35-0. Peru leads under 7 to play in the third quarter. And who's coming on? I gotta believe it.
Yeah, it's hard to. Peru's numbers are hard to read when they get in that offensive set. It's hard to see who's there.
McConaughey to Walker. And Walker's tackled as he falls across the 30 to about the 31. Picks up about 4 there. It'll be second down and 6. So Rochester girls and guys basketball having a golf outing October 1st at Mill Creek.
Okay.
I don't have all the details.
The fundraiser for the basketball program.
Yep. And this is big, and I think this is going to be a great fundraiser for the kids.
I'm not sure what they're raising funds for, but it's a fundraiser.
Yeah. Second and 6. Flag on the play, and dragging the pile ahead again is Clauser. Clauser takes it across the 35 to the 36, but there's a flag on the play. Well, holding against the Peru Tigers, so that'll back him up 10.
That might be their second negative play of the night.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Steve. So the Rochester golf outing will be October 1st at the Rochester Round Barn Golf Course. Tee time, 9 o'clock. Let's see. Rochester boys and girls basketball programs bring current and former players together, along with fans and alumni, to enjoy the golf tournament on the first. And I'll get you some fees here in a minute. Second down and about 13 here for Peru after the penalty. Here's a play off the left side. Doesn't go very far. Nice job by the Rochester front 4 or 5 from blowing that one up in the backfield. And it's going to bring up third down after a no gain. Fee, $60 a player, $225 for a team, 24 maximum teams, sponsors, donor levels available as well. For more information, call Tony Stasiak at 223-2111. 2176, extension 4210, or Rex Reinholdt at 223-2176, extension 4211. Third and 13. McConaughey out of the shotgun formation gives to the fullback Clauser. He drags the pile ahead to his own 30. And on comes the punting unit as Clauser picks up about 5 yards. It'll bring up fourth down and eight.
This will be the first punt this evening for the Peru Tigers. And the first possession that they haven't scored on tonight.
Wood back deep. Jay Walker will punt from about his 15-yard line for the Tigers, who lead 35 to nothing with 4:40 to play in the third. Walker, no pressure, gets it away. Wood runs up on it, takes it to hop. Oh, it bounces off of Wood's shin or his thigh pad and right up into his hands. That was dangerous.
He made a poor decision to let that ball hit the ground because Peru did an excellent job of getting defenders downfield. They met Wood before the ball hit the ground, and boy, that ball hit the ground and then immediately hit Wood.
Yeah.
The defenders were right there to make contact. Wood lucky to get a hold of it and maintain possession.
So Rochester, after dodging a bullet, will take this one at their own 38. Ball on the far hash going to our left. Davis and Wood to the near side. Jackson and Dalton to the right side, short side of the field. Pearson in the pistol. Pitches off to Dalton. Dalton was the fullback that time, and he runs ahead to the 45-yard line.
Good quick spurt by Dalton.
I believe Jacob Good was the wide out to the right. The plumber brings a play in from the sideline. Rochester quickly in the huddle, breaks the huddle. Good and Jackson wide to the right. Plumber and Wood wide to the left. Out of the pistol, Pearson on second down at about four. Snap, pitches again to Dalton. Wilson lowers his head at the 45, falls across to the 46. Going to come up short of a first down. It'll bring up third down at about two for the Z's. 3:52 to play in the third quarter. Rochester down 35 to nothing. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. You want to golf in that?
31st?
No, the first.
The first. October 1st.
You can practice on 31st if
you probably
like.
Could. You going to put a team together?
Maybe.
Yeah. I'm right there if you need a putter.
Well, I'm usually the driver.
You find somebody to get us from the tee box to the green,
and I'm
your man.
Okay. Third and two. Abbott right up the middle. He's got a first down. Whoa, he was spun around at the stick. Wow, I thought he had it. And Peru stopped him right at the stick. Boy, that's going to be close.
Rochester's going to get the home field advantage. They're going to get a first down.
Give him three. First and 10 for the Z's at their own 48. 3:10 to play, third quarter. Peru leads 35 to nothing here at Barnhart Field next week on the road. For the first time this season, we'll go to South Whitley to battle the Whitco Wildcats, who last I heard was leading convincingly over the Mechanical Braves.
Yeah, I'm looking for that score. Yeah, 28 to nothing.
Jackson motion to the near side. On the option, Pearson coming to the near side. Keeps, tucks it up, runs down to the 41.
Rochester doing a good job of running the option that time as the offensive line did a great job of holding their block. Pearson holding the football. Jackson ran right with him, but no need to pitch it.
Give him about 13 yards and a Zebra first down at the Peru 40. Pearson quickly on the ball. Dalton behind him. Four wide outs for the Zebras. Ball in the near hash on first and 10. On the option, Dalton right up the middle. Stuck at the 39, and that's about it. As he gets maybe a yard as he hit, ran hard to get that one. It'll be second and 9. Wilson Dalton brings maybe just a little bit more explosiveness right now from that fullback position. Second and 9 for Rochester. Good and Jackson go right. Wood and Powell go left. Pistol is Pearson. Ross brings Wood in motion on the jet sweep. Wood goes in motion to the right and gets the carry going right. And there's a flag on the play as Wood gets carried Carries the ball inside the 25-yard line. Makes it the, I'm sorry, 35-yard line down to around the 33. But I believe we're going to have a hold on the Rochester Zebras, indeed.
And it is.
2 minutes to play, third quarter. 35 to nothing. Can North Miami score? Castle leads 20 to nothing over the West Central Trojans. Thank you, Val. North White and Sheridan. Wow.
Right.
Second and 16. High snap. Pearson jumps up, brings it down, pitches out to Jackson. Jackson takes it to the Peru 46. Clock rolls and down to 100 seconds to play in the third quarter. Third and 16 now for Rochester. Davis brings the play in from the sideline. Ball in the near hash, which is the Rochester sideline. Short side of the field is Davis and Wood. Wide side is good and Jackson. Pearson in the pistol formation. Jackson comes in motion to the near side on third and 16. Back to pass to Pearson. Throws it down the far sideline. It is picked off by the Tigers. Picked off by the secondary and returned up the sideline and ran out of bounds just shy of the Tigers' 40-yard line. And Pearson is on the ground. Helmet off.
And again, he took a shot right to the midsection as he jumped up to throw that one. And let's hope that it's just got the wind knocked out of him.
We're going to take an injury timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Ross Pearson runs off the field under his own power, and on the first play after the interception, Schlosser runs for 6 yards. The quarterback, McConaughey, spun down right at the stick. And that'll do it for, well,
he'll pick up about two, I think.
That's going to do it for the third quarter. After the third, Peru leads 35 to nothing. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Thank you. back at Rochester High School.
Wow. Valley scores the 52-6 Tippecanoe Valley over
North Miami over Valley.
Valley, yeah, in the third quarter.
First and 10 for the Tigers as we start this fourth quarter. You know, a couple of weeks ago, before the season started, when all the scrimmages were happening here at Rochester, we had a
Buick test drive
with Shepherd Chevrolet.
Yes. Yep.
And the thing was, if we could get
a 500 test drive papers filled out, brochure or pamphlets filled out, that they'd donate $20 for every one. And Rochester came up three short of that 500.
Yep.
So they got $9,940. That'll go to the athletic department of Rochester High School. So if you came out and filled out one of them forms for the test drive, thank you.
Absolutely.
Rochester's athletic department is going to be, and all athletics at Rochester High School will be better for it. So, and thank you to Buick and Shepherd Chevrolet for sponsoring that.
So Isaac Hall, a freshman for the Peru Tigers, takes them into Rochester territory at the 40-yard line. It'll be first and 10. New quarterback in the game for Peru is Darian Cleaver, I believe. Darian Cleaver is a 5'10 sophomore for the Tigers. He takes a snap and he'll keep it right up the middle. Cleaver is driven backwards after a couple of yards gained. Anthony Tinsman there with a stop for the Rochester Zebras. So Cleaver gets the carry, picks up four. It'll be second down and six under 11 minutes to play in the game against Peru, up 35-0. And that was what the score was after the first quarter. No, 28-0 after
at
one.
Half, yeah.
At halftime it was. And Bob Prescott midway, well, in the beginning of the second quarter, coach for the Peru Tigers, called off the dog.
Yeah, he's been running the second and third string in for Peru, and they've been content to run the more simple dive plays.
Before the play is ran there, we have a false start, I believe, on the Peru Tigers. That'll back him up 5 yards, I'm guessing.
For a few other scores, Witko, whom Rochester will travel to play next week, leads McConaughey 28-0. Northfield leads Southwood 14-0. Last report, Wabash over Manchester 20-7. Winnemac leads Coach Mike Zahner's Culver Cavaliers 14-7. Caston 20-0 over West Central. Plymouth and Warsaw are now tied 10-10 in the third quarter. Pioneer over Triton 29-0.
That penalty whistled against the Zebras. Neutral zone infraction, so it'll be second down and one for the Tigers right now. Cleaver
watching the clock, play clock run down.
Yeah, why not? Down to 10 on the play clock, sets the line of scrimmage. Takes a snap, and now they're going to have another penalty.
Start against Peru.
So we'll back him up five, so it'll be second down and six after the penalty.
As long as the play clock keeps running.
Game clock.
I'm just on that game clock, yeah. Just over 10 minutes here in the fourth.
35-0 Peru. They get on the road next week to Witko.
And they look to start the conference off 1-0 and 3-0 on the season.
Cleaver, hands off to Steele. Jake Steele going to the left. He's tackled right around the 30-yard line. And it looks like from the spot on the far side, he's going to have enough for a first down, giving him seven. And a Tiger first down. The ball will be at the Rochester 30-yard line, going to our left.
Had 10 different people carry the football for Peru tonight.
No kidding.
Yeah. Geisen only carried the ball four times. He's got 110 yards.
They were on first and 10. Take a snap. Gives it to the fullback. Hall. And Hall, right up the middle, picks up 12 and another Peru Tiger first down. Ball inside the 20-yard line, first and 10 for the Tigers. Under nine to play in the game, 35-0. Peru on top. Cleaver in the shotgun formation. Hall to his left. From the Rochester 19, Hall gets the carry going right. But I believe there's another flag on the play. It'll be a false start on the Peru Tigers.
Be curious to know when the last time North Miami started the season 3-0.
Yeah.
I mean, that's three blowouts to start the season for North Miami.
So first and 15 after a five-yard walk-off against the Tigers. Ball to 24 of the Rochester Zebras, middle of the field. Michael Chandler now the quarterback. Hall off the left side. Wow, this kid's going to be pretty good.
Yeah,
Isaac Hall.
Quick.
Yeah, takes it inside the 15 to the 14-yard line.
10-yard gain for Hall.
Numbers are really hard to see.
Yeah, they are. I have not, I think, seen a jersey number all night. I've just been, whatever you say is what I write down.
I like it. I like it.
You are always right in my book, Musk.
8 minutes to play in the football game. It's second down and five after, like Brad said, a 10-yard run for Hall. Cleaver in the game as the quarterback. Takes it going right.
The sports historian here in the press box, Val Pretorius, of course, from the Rochester Sentinel, says it's 2007 the last time North Miami started off at 3-0 season.
Joe Grant was the quarterback.
Interesting.
Third down, 3 yard gain.
We've got a coach with that name.
We do. That came from North Miami.
I am sharp.
What do you know?
Right on top of that, aren't
you? You think you're going to make it through the K-State game tonight? You're crazy. Third down and two for the Peru Tigers deep into Rochester territory. Cleaver keeps it.
Still looking
patient. Working to the right side. Now back up towards the middle of the field. Takes it inside the Rochester 5. It'll be first and goal for the Tigers. How about that for a youngster? He didn't rush it. He let the block develop in front of him.
It almost looked like he was like, get out of my way so I can run this thing. Waiting on his offensive lineman to move or open a hole, one of the two.
First and goal for the Tigers at about the 2-yard line. Cleaver to the line of scrimmage. Hall to his left.
Yep, motion on the Zebras.
Half the distance. So
yep,
that's what it's going to be, the one. That's the second or third offsides in this drive.
First and goal from the three.
20-7, Wabash leads Manchester. Gets Wabash close to scoring again.
Yeah.
That'll carry off the left. And touchdown, Tigers.
Yep.
Who was that?
Quarterback keeper?
Okay.
McConaughey?
Sure. No.
No?
Cleaver.
Cleaver.
So,
3 yards out.
It's 41-0. And the extra point attempt by the Tigers coming up. 7:10 to play in the football game. And it looks like Peru will go for two. Cleaver, your quarterback, all to the left. Cleaver will take it, going right, looking for the end zone, and the two-point conversion is good. 43-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Welcome back to Rochester High School. 6:10 to play in the football game. Peru now up 43-0. Well, I was just informed the Cubs' magic number now is 14.
Seems about right. That's kind of a that's kind of weird because, you know, I've been a Cubs fan for a long, long time, and, you know, the nice thing about that was they were usually done by the time football season started. So I don't know how to act now with them still in the hunt.
Yeah, I think they're a little bit more than in the hunt at this point.
Maybe the best record in Major League Baseball. We'll
yeah, right.
We don't want to say too much, but, you know, still 1st of September.
The Tigers will kick.
Cub fans tend to be a little superstitious.
Oh, I think they probably have every right to be.
Yep.
Low line drive kick, taken at the 25-yard line by Dalton. Dalton runs over a tackler at the 40 and gets ahead to the 41 or 2. Nice hard run by Wilson Dalton. And the Zebras will take over this possession, or this series will start at about the 42-yard line. 6 minutes to play in the game. The Tigers up 43-0. And Drew Saylor, the quarterback
for the Zebras. We saw him warming up after halftime there at the start of the third quarter. See if he can, he gets a little bit of protection, a little bit of time. We'll see if he can air it out. Saylor's under center.
Yep, Saylor takes it.
Snap. That, he hands off to
Bryce Baker.
Baker. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, and Peru is all over that in the backfield.
2nd and 10. Good comes into the game. Also, Bryce Baker, a 5'9 sophomore, is your fullback. Also in the game for the Rochester Zebras, Garrett Gray. He comes wide to the near side. Saylor's on the pistol. Good goes in motion to the left side on the jet sweep. I think the ball's loose.
Good's going to fall on it.
There's a huge pile on the left side of the field, and I think Rochester's going to keep possession, but Good is going to lose a yard. We'll bring up 3rd down and 11. Culver and Winnemac. 12 seconds to go. Culver is going for a 2-point conversion to win it.
Oh, wow.
Randy Zahner. Bryce, you had a time to text that to me.
No kidding.
Saylor's complete to Good on the near side at the 40. And Good is going to be brought down at about the 41-yard line. Not a lot there. It'll be 4th down.
That doesn't surprise me with Coach Z. We saw him in a sectional game at Twin Lake a couple of years ago with the game tied, and he threw it in the end zone when everybody in the world was screaming, kick the field goal. Yeah.
4th down and 12 as that play goes for a minus one and on the kick for the Z's, Duff. And the Culver Cavaliers complete the 2-point conversion and now lead by 2 with 10 seconds to play in that game. Duff, a nice high kick, takes a Rochester bounce inside the 30, inside the 25, and will come to rest at about the 21-yard line. So Rochester, make that Peru will start this possession at their own 21, ball in the near hash. 4 minutes to play in the game. Tigers up 43-0.
Well, Pioneer extended their lead in the second half. 43-0 now over Triton.
Hall's your fullback. And the quarterback for the Tigers. Hang on, I'll get that for you. It's Chandler, Michael Chandler. I believe Hall was the ball carrier off the right side of the huge chunk of change. Gets it out to the 30-yard line. Picks up about 9. That'll bring up 2nd down and 1 for the Tigers. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 2nd and 9. The Tigers at their own 30-yard line. Chandler, out of the shotgun, takes a snap, gives the running back from the left side off the left side of the line, Gets it to the 42 and another Tiger first down. Not sure, was that 10? No, 20 maybe. Hood, Shannon Hood. First and 10 for the Tigers at their own 37-yard line with 2:50 to play in the game. Chandler in the backfield. To his left is Steele. Steele takes the carry right. Pops it to the outside. Yep. Steele's got a first down.
Defender down fell
the
down and
sideline and is tackled right around midfield.
Steele was able to pick up 11 yards as the defender for Rochester fell down at the line of scrimmage. Safety wasn't able to come over until after he picked up the first down.
Ball at the 49-yard line of the Tigers for 10. And the 2 minutes to play in the game. Post-game show coming up next. Lafayette Harrison defeated Logan 39-0. Thank you, Val. 8 on the play clock. Chandler. Hands off. Cleaver is now the tailback of the halfback. And Cleaver, nothing there. It'll be 2nd and 10. Minute 40 to play in the game. Rochester going to slip to 0-3, 0-1 of the TRC. Peru going to improve to 2-1 and 1-0 in the Three Rivers Conference. Rochester next week will hit the road for the first time this year and battle the Whitkill Wildcats at Whitkill High School. Minute 20 from the 49. Play goes to the right. Now off of the races. Call from behind. As he takes the ball inside the 35 of Rochester at about the 31.
And Rochester and player is down. Who was the running back for Peru?
I don't know.
Okay.
Is that good on the ground? He's on his belly.
Yep.
Rolling around. Christina Hughes out there. 55 seconds to play in the game. Peru up 43-0. And we've got an injured zebra, so we'll take a timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Back at Rochester High School, Bryce Baker was the young man helped off the field. Maybe with lost the wind knocked him a little bit. And Peru, after that injury timeout, takes a snap, kneels on it, and that'll do it. The final from Rochester High School, the Peru Tigers defeat the Zebras 43-0. Post-game show coming up next, 92.1 WROI.